the perverse incentives of the military-industrial complex, synthetic consciousness, corporate greed and corruption, private military contractors, the death of a child. These themes and many more were present in the third season of Yu-Gi-Oh!, one of the least popular seasons from the original series run. I wanted to discuss in today's video some of my opinions about this season and why I think it's underrated in hindsight. Hey, what's going on, folks? Welcome back to the Parkside Merchant channel. For those of you that are new to our channel, we talk about a lot of topics related to vintage trading cards, especially vintage Yu-Gi-Oh!, and sometimes talk a bit about the anime and the lore and some of the other elements that drive a lot of people's interest in this particular franchise. So I invite everybody to like, comment, subscribe if you're interested in this kind of content to help support our channel. So the topic for today's video is Season 3 of the original Yu-Gi-Oh! Series. For a lot of folks, people really enjoyed the Battle City Tournament. That was Season 2 of the original series. And then Season 1 obviously had a lot of fans. That was the original run at Duelist Kingdom, right? You had Pegasus as the main villain. Just a very dynamic and very interesting season. Yu-Gi-Oh! Was still kind of finding its way. The card game was just getting really popular around that 2002 timeframe, and so there's a lot of nostalgia and a lot of positive sentiment around Season 1, Season 2. Battle City obviously had the Egyptian God cards. You had Merrick, the Rare Hunters, all this stuff that made it a very dynamic and very interesting season to watch as kids because it was very entertaining and just a very interesting show to follow when you could buy all the cards that were played on the show as well. Now you get to Season 3 at this point, which is coming off the heels of a very successful Season 1, Season 2. Yu-Gi-Oh! Had kind of been on fire for about a year and a half, 2 years. Some would argue peak Yu-Gi-Oh! had been reached. Everybody was all into Battle City, Egyptian God cards, dual discs, right? All this sort of stuff was getting popular around that time. Season 3 comes along, and some people were getting fatigued. There were people that were leaving the hobby. I think for some folks, it was kind of a fad. They were starting to lose interest in the hobby. And Season 3 was kind of seen as a little bit less interesting, right? It kind of fell a little flat relative to what people were used to from the Battle City tournament. So I totally agree with a lot of these sentiments, right? I'm not here to argue that Season 3 is better than Season 2 or Season 1 necessarily, but I do think in hindsight it's a little bit underrated. And I also think in hindsight that some of the themes that this season contended with were probably a little too mature for the average age audience at the time, which was mostly kids, middle school aged kids and younger kids, frankly, that were playing the cards at the time. So let's start with the topics, right? And I'll avoid spoilers for folks that haven't watched this in a long time or that haven't seen it, but basically it's a continuation of the Battle City narrative, right? They're still coming down the home stretch, approaching the finals for the Battle City tournament with Merrick and Kaiba, Yugi, Joey, right? All the mainstay characters that you're used to. People remember from Battle City, they were on a blimp, like a big dirigible. And long story short, as they're flying out to the finals, right, they get intercepted by Noah Kaiba, who is basically, you learn over the course of the season, is basically a stepbrother to Kaiba, to Seto Kaiba. And there's a whole backstory that gets investigated with the Big Five and Kaiba Corporation. You learn all sorts of stuff about Kaiba's relationship with his adopted father, Gozaburo Kaiba, who was basically the chairman and CEO of Kaiba Corporation. And the show really gets back into the Big Five, right? Some of these major characters, some of these villains, they're part of the board of directors and the senior executive offices for Kaiba Corporation. And in many ways, it is sort of a continuation of the Battle City tournament. The only exception is that it's not really Battle City matches, but it's basically Yugi and all of his friends dueling against the Big Five, Noah Kaiba, and some of these other Kaiba affiliates. So I think part of the negative reaction to the season was people just weren't as interested in Noah Kaiba, Gozaburo Kaiba, the Big Five, as villains. People liked Merrick, the Rare Hunters. Those were cool villains and antagonists. I guess to a degree, Noah Kaiba and Gozaburo were less interesting and maybe a little more boring, right? It was all corporate focused. The Big Five were just a bunch of corporate executives, so I think for some folks that was kind of boring and maybe not kid-friendly with respect to what those antagonists looked like and just how they behaved. It was just kind of boring, right? A bunch of suits that were basically the main villains for the season. You add into that that it was dealing with some very heavy subject matter, and you have to remember this in the context of 2003, 2002, right? You kind of had the war on terror just escalating in the Middle East, and there were a lot of mixed opinions about the military-industrial complex and some of the incentives of private military contractors. And so this show obviously did start dabbling into how Kaiba Corporation kind of got involved in military conflicts. They were making profits off of destructive weapons that were being used in malicious ways and things like that. So there were some very heavy topics and subjects that were getting covered in the series. You layer into that that you learn over the course of the season that Noah Kaiba disappeared, but by deduction, you kind of learn this guy probably died as a kid. And, you know, I don't want to spoil the season too much, but there's some very heavy stuff that happens in here. And then you've got this whole element of Gozaburo Kaiba treating his adopted son worse than his genetic son. Just like some very heavy stuff that happens in there. And I think for a young audience, it wasn't really all that interesting and it was kind of boring. But in hindsight, it was some very deep and very interesting commentary to think about. And I think as I've gotten older, I've grown more sympathetic to the season. I just rewatched it last year and I really enjoyed it. I mean, it was an interesting season. I thought the plot was very well crafted. You still had a lot of the characters that we liked. Like Merrick is still there in season three. So are many of the people on the blimp, right? You've still got Odeon and you still have a bunch of these other people that are still kicking around in season three. So it's not like it was a full-fledged departure from Battle City. If anything, it was just more of a continuation that had an interlude with this whole interesting Gozaburo Kaiba narrative. So I think for me, I actually kind of enjoyed season three. There were a lot of fun cards that came out of season three. You had monsters like the Yamada Dragon, Shinato, King of a Higher Plane, Yadagarasu, Injection Fairy Lily. A lot of big monsters came out of season three and got used by some of the protagonists and antagonists. So I think that element in conjunction with the fact that the plot was pretty interesting and pretty heavy and a pretty good watch if you've grown up a lot, right, since the time you first saw it, you see different stuff and you pick up on different things when you rewatch the season. So in my personal opinion, season three is probably just as good or just as interesting as season two. And maybe even more complex or more developed than season one, which had a very basic narrative. Yu-Gi-Oh! Was still trying to figure out its way as a franchise. There was all sorts of production peculiarities with season one especially. I feel like season three at that point, Yu-Gi-Oh! Knew what it was doing as a franchise. They had a good narrative, good plot, good villains, good characters, and a good story. So I guess those are just some of my reflections and thoughts on season three. I think it gets a bad rap unnecessarily just because people didn't enjoy it as kids, but the subject matter in hindsight was actually quite interesting, in my opinion, relative to some of the other plot lines that get explored over the course of the original television series. So I think that's all here for this video, folks. Let me know in the comments, what did you think of season three of the Yu-Gi-Oh! Series? Did you like it? Did you not like it? How did it compare to the other seasons? Do you feel like it's underrated in hindsight? Let me know down below what you think. As always, appreciate everybody's time here. Feel free to like and subscribe to our channel to help support us. Once again, this is the Parkside Merchants channel, and we'll see you next time. We'll be right back.